Hello again. A quick follow-up to my recent VGA to EGA conversion video. As Molotov Popsicle pointed out on Reddit, these EGA Dithered games were not meant to be displayed on modern LCD screens. And there's a reason for that that I want to go into today. And I also want to show you how you can emulate these effects that CRT screens had on Dithered graphics on modern displays. Without going too much into detail why and how, the shadow mask of CRT displays produced a less sharp image than modern LCD displays. This meant that individual pixels were less visible and kind of bleeded into each other. That's why many retro gamers prefer CRT screens for older games, as they tend to produce a more natural image than modern displays. Another effect of this property is that the lines between the pixels became blurred and melted into a single color to a certain extent. This way, the limited EGA color palette was able to mix different colors together, creating more than the hardware would theoretically allow for. This all obviously depends on the model of the CRT and its settings. Sometimes it worked better, other times worse. Getting a CRT these days can be quite expensive, as they are not produced anymore and shipping is costly. Also, many people, myself included, simply don't have the desk space to set up one of these monsters. But if you're still curious on how this color blending looked like, or at least an approximation, you can use filters in your DOS box to emulate the look of a CRT. There are many different filters, and in the end, which one works best for you comes down to personal preference, so I wanted to give you a few examples and recommendations for this special use case. You can find a download link to the DOSBox version I have been using for this in the video description. First, as a reminder, this is how the game looks without any filters. The first filter I want to show you is the CRT LOTS mod filter, which was selected by default in this DOSBox version. As you can see, it has a cool CRT aesthetics, but the dithering lines are still very visible. If you don't like the curved image, which, by the way, emulates the curved surface of the older TV screens, you can use the CRT LOTS without Bogen filter instead. The next one is called Fixing Pixel Art. This one does a very nice job on color blending. The vertical dither lines disappear almost completely, and it adds these little cells mimicking the shadow mask of old CRT displays. It's definitely on the stronger side and also a bit dark, which kind of makes sense as CRTs used to be less bright than modern LED screens. Lastly, we have the GTU shader. This one also does a very good job at blurring the dithering patterns while also being very bright and high contrast. It also adds scan lines, another artifact that you had on CRT's displays back then. Unfortunately, the brightness and contrast tend to overshoot, making many games look completely off. I tested the shader with a variety of games. Some, like Laura Bow and Echo Quest 2, look great, at least as far as I have played them. Other, like Freddy Farkas and Fate of Atlantis, look really bad. So, that's it for this little update. I have a few more clips of games running on the Fixing Pixel Art filter at the end. I wanted to say thank you for your support and welcome to the many new subscribers from the last video. That was great. And with that, see ya!
Thank you.